What's up everybody and welcome to the channel. Today we're going to take a look at this 2024 BMW M240i xDrive. This one's finished in Portimeo Blue. MSRP is about $58,000. So this is going to be a full point of view style look at this car. We'll double pull that latch and let's see what is going to power the 240. So underneath the hood, if you're familiar with the Supra, this has the same B58, which is a 3-liter inline 6-cylinder turbocharged motor pumping out 382 horsepower with 369 pound-feet of torque. Can do 0 to 60 in about 4.1 seconds. Curb weight is 3,800 pounds. And with a 13.7 gallon fuel tank, you can still get 23 miles per gallon in the city with 32 out on the highway. Moving to the styling, this color is amazing for this car. It looks so good, especially with the satin silver trim. We have LED headlights, some darker color for the housing, and then I like the silver trim surrounding the grille. It's got that kidney-shaped design, active grille shutters, forward-facing camera, and your BMW badge. And then I really like these triangle-shaped vents, really cool looking. They're huge to allow a lot of cooling into the radiator on the side. Got parking sensors, some aggressive lines, nice sharp line right there. And then gloss black trim down below, safety sensor, and more openings to provide maximum cooling. I also like the sharp line throughout the hood, just gives it kind of like a baby M3 design, just a little bit more aggression. Really aggressive front, it looks good, nice and modern. Nice longer hood, just to add to the style with this car. And then you're gonna see a cool set of two-tone wheels, split five spoke. I like the blue color on those calipers. And then a sharp line surrounding this front wheel. You have one prominent body line on the upper section, gloss black side skirts with a little bit more aggression to it, and I like these new flush mounted door handles. You have more of the satin color, side view camera along with an LED turn signal, then all gloss black trim surrounding the windows. Sunroof up on top, small shark fin antenna, and I like the side profile of the 2 Series Coupe. It's pretty short and stubby, makes it look pretty aggressive. And I like how the fenders are a little bit wider. It gives it that more aggressive design. You can see how everything is designed to that. Definitely a sporty looking car. In back, you're going to see the LED taillights. Nice three-dimensional look with black and red. You got the M240 and xDrive badge back here. Cool contours within the trunk and a small lip spoiler. And then a pretty big gloss black diffuser with nice looking exhaust tips. I don't think you can complain with the design. I think they did a really good job. I overall really like it. Nice and tall looking in the back too, just to add to that aggression. And then in back, we can just press the button and pop the trunk. And you have a really good sized trunk back here. This is a pretty practical car. Huge opening as well. Then there's a little bit of cargo on this left side and you can pull the handles up above and that's gonna unlatch these back seats. So if we go in through the side, there's a handle back here. Just pull that, a little awkward angle. But pulling that, the seat is gonna automatically slide forwards and we can take a look at the back seats. It seats two people back here with those unlocked already. Of course, we can just pull these down. The headrests themselves also fold out of the way, which is a good touch to see, but really is a pretty practical car. Also in the center, you can pull that down, armrests along with two cup holders, and then the entire seat itself folds down as well. So you can have some more access into the trunk. So I think for a two-door car, it's definitely practical for people and cargo. And then if I go ahead and hop into the back seat at 5'11", we'll go ahead and put this one back up. But sitting back here, you have two air vents, some cargo. And then if you do that, it's gonna automatically come back to where I had it set at my height. So sitting here, it's a little cramped. My knees obviously are getting a little crushed. But not too bad, you know, my head is touching the ceiling. However, it's pretty doable. You do have a lot of glass, a few good amenities. So in a pinch, two people really, not too bad back here. If you slouch a little bit wide in your legs, it's not that bad. And then from here, I can just pull that. The seat's gonna automatically get out of the way as well. Both seats are gonna do the same thing. And then we can just climb right out. So this interior is the cognac. It is a synthetic leather material. It feels nice though. Of the synthetic leathers out there, it's pretty nice. So you have some contours in the door panel, which looks pretty neat. I like the contrast with this whole piece. A little bit of padding, a good size grab handle, memory seating, lock, unlock, window controls, a little bit of storage, and then the M logo on the door sill. You're gonna see power controls along with lumbar support, manual leg rest, and then the perforations throughout the center. Nice bolsters. These are really comfortable seats. Not crazy sporty. This obviously isn't the M2, but it is a pretty nice sporty and luxurious interior. Foot on the brake, let's fire it up. So you have the massive screen now, which not everyone's the biggest fan of. It is two separate screens within it. Honestly, it does look pretty good. So right in the center, we can go ahead and adjust climate, adjust all of that, heated seats and everything. On the gauge cluster, we have a massive tach and speedometer, and with your different drive modes, it changes everything. So you have the Eco Pro mode, comfort mode, and then sport mode. So pretty nice to see that. We also have a few different ones. You can have sport, sport individual, so you can really configure a lot of what this car has to offer. You can also toggle just a little bit throughout the center screen, seeing a few trip information. Cruise control on the left side, heated steering wheel button, and then some Bluetooth and audio on the right with paddle shifters. The right stalk is for all your windshield wipers, left one is gonna be your turn signals and the automatic high beam control. Headlight controls are over here with one of your air vents, heads up display system, and then just a nice black material for the whole dash, piano black, and some silver trim. This is the new BMW infotainment screen. You have quite a lot on here. You can easily swipe over and see all the different tabs that are gonna pop up within the car. So I think it's actually pretty easy to use. Once you get used to it, it might take just a little bit of time. You have different apps in the car, going back to home. You have shortcuts over here. You also have all the apps you're gonna be able to see. And then if we go back to home, you have shortcuts for audio control, phone, of course, and then a full screen navigation. So it does work really nice, pretty easy to use once you get used to it. Pushing that forward into reverse, we get a backup camera, top-down view. You also have a 3D camera view, and I like how whenever you tap one of these, it's gonna go to the different sides. So pretty cool the way it's set up. We have a park button as well. And then you're gonna see climate, vents down below, volume, track, hazards, defrost, and then a cool texture material for this plastic center. If we push that open, we have the slot right here for the key fob, which you can use as a credit card. There's a cool one that it comes with. You also have cup holders, USB and a 12 volt, traction control, shortcut to camera and parking, of course your drive modes, brake hold, any electronic parking brake, and then the rotary dial, like any BMW, you have a lot of shortcuts. So you can really easily adjust what's on the screen, go into different things. You have shortcuts as well. So it just makes it pretty easy. You don't always have to use the touchscreen. You have this right here. You have a nice armrest with the same material, storage down below, and then a pretty good sized glove box. And then one last look at the interior. Nice place to be for sure. Really good visibility, huge sun visor for that sunroof with the controls, LED dome lights, garage door buttons underneath the mirror, and then a nice sized sun visor. All right, setting off now in the 240. Hopefully you can hear that. There are some nice little pops and stuff once you let off the gas. This thing is quick. Of course, I own a Toyota Supra. This motor with the xDrive and the 8-speed, I mean, this car is fun to drive. We've been in the M2 as well. This is a pretty fun car so far. Of course, it's nice, normal, and comfortable. But when you're in the Sport Plus mode, you got the massive gauges and everything, playing with the paddles. This car is super responsive. Of course, we're not ripping on it being brand new, but you can tell there is so much power to give in this car. And with this drive mode in the Sport Plus, the steering is tight, suspension feels really good. For a practical car at the end of the day, this is really fun and sporty. I really like that. If we go back in the drive, Eco Pro mode and everything, the car tones down. The steering is a lot more lazy, suspension softer. It's a nice, normal, comfortable, refined luxury car, honestly. And for 58 grand, I feel like it's a really good value. Doesn't seem expensive for what you're getting in this car. Great visibility, the tech works well, it's easy to use while driving. I like this new screen, I'm getting used to it, and I think at the end of the day, it does look and feel really good. Materials, everything's nice, the seats are comfortable, windshield's huge, windows are huge in back. I mean, this is an absolute fantastic daily driver. No issues there. And then when we go back into all the sport modes, I really do like how when you go here, you get that cool screen. But the car just wakes up. I love every gear change. You feel and hear a little bit of thunder behind you. It really adds to the fun factor in this car. I don't think there's any complaints with just the normal driving dynamics. It seems like a very well-balanced car to give you the luxury, but also to give you the performance and sports car feeling. It seems really composed, easy to place too. It doesn't feel like a big car. Obviously, it's not a big car, but it's just easy to drive around. Sweepers and everything, just nice. Really well balanced. I don't think I have any driving complaints. It seems like a good place to be, and I think it offers quite a lot for the money. Yeah, BMW M240. Put this on your list if you want a practical two-door car that is actually a real sports car at the end of the day. This thing's pretty quick, and with that all-wheel drive, it's going to be able to handle circumstances that other cars just aren't going to do. So definitely take a look at the M240.